we want to factor and solve the given quadratic equations. Now that we've learned several techniques for factoring, it's important that we don't forget about the first step in factoring, which is to factor out the greatest common factor. Looking at our first example, we have 4x squared minus 2x minus 20 equals 0. So again, the first thing we should do is look for a common factor, and notice that all these terms do have a common factor of 2. So let's start by factoring out 2 and see what's left. We'd have 2x squared minus x minus 10 equals 0. So now even though this trinomial factor does not have a leading coefficient of 1, it will make it much easier to factor this further. So again, if this trinomial factor does factor again, it would factor into two binomial factors, where the first terms of the binomial factors would come from the factors of 2x squared. That'd have to be 2x and x. And now the second positions of the binomial factors must come from the factors of negative 10, so that the sum of the inner and outer product is equal to negative 1x. And there's not too many factors of negative 10 to try. We could use negative 1 times 10, negative 10 times 1, negative 2 times 5, or negative 5 times 2. And we know since this trinomial didn't have any common factors, the binomial factors won't have any common factors either, meaning we would not put a multiple of 2 here because of this 2x. So let's try putting a positive 5 here and a negative 2 here, and now we'll check the sum of the inner and outer products. Inner product is positive 5x, the outer product is negative 4x. Notice how this sum would be x or 1x, and we want negative 1x. So we have the right number, wrong sign, and that's very easy to fix. We'll just change this to minus 5 and change this to plus 2. Notice by doing this, the inner product is negative 5x, and the outer product is 4x. Therefore, we do have our negative 1x, which is the middle term. So now we know this is factored correctly. And because this product is equal to 0, we can now use a zero product property to solve this equation. This 2 out here does not contain a variable, so it's not going to give us a solution. But the factor of 2x minus 5 must equal 0, or the factor of x plus 2 must equal 0. So here we'll add 5 to both sides and then divide by 2. So we have x equals 5 halves. Here we would subtract 2 on both sides. So we have x equals negative 2. Okay, let's take a look at our second example. Here we have 5x squared minus 125 equals 0. Again, the first step is to look for the greatest common factor, which in this case would be 5. So let's factor out 5 and then see what's left. If we factor out 5, we'd have x squared, and there's 25 fives in 125. So we'd have x squared minus 25 equals 0. And again, notice how as soon as we factored out the greatest common factor, we should recognize this as a difference of squares. So we can factor this again. So we're still going to have this extra factor of 5. But now it's going to factor again into two binomial factors. So the factors of x squared would be x and x. The factors of 25 would be 5 and 5. And because we have a difference of squares, one of the factors would be x plus 5, and one would be x minus 5. And again, because this product is equal to 0, either the factor of x plus 5 must equal 0, or the factor of x minus 5 must equal 0. So here, subtracting 5 on both sides, we would have x equals negative 5. Here we would add 5 to both sides, giving us a solution of x equals positive 5. So here are our two solutions. And if we wanted to, we could write this as x equals plus or minus 5, a shorter way to represent a solution of positive 5 and negative 5. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.